नमस्ते बिटिया, सदा खुश रहो। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर हेमंत व्यास, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सर्जरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्प्रेंड एंकल। लेट्स बिगिन। एंकल इज द मोस्ट कॉमन साइट फॉर लिगामेंट इंजुरी इन द बॉडी। It is the term, it means sprained ankle is a term used for ligament injuries of the ankle. Commonly it is an inversion injury and the lateral collateral ligament is sprained. So this thing has to be kept in mind because this question can be asked many times in multiple choice questions. I repeat, inversion injury. Sprained ankle is most commonly an inversion injury and lateral collateral ligament is sprained most of the time. Sometimes an eversion force may result in a sprain of the medial collateral ligament of the ankle. So in this diagram we can see a normal foot in the middle. On the left side there is inversion of the foot in which the lateral ligament is affected, and on my right side there is eversion in which medial ligament is sprained. Here we can see the details of ligaments which are affected in the sprain. Now let's see clinical features. The patient gives history of a twisting injury to the ankle followed by pain and swelling over the injured ligament. Weight bearing gives rise to excruciating pain. In cases with complete tears, patient gives a history of feeling of something tearing at the time of injury. There may be swelling and tenderness localized to the site of the torn ligament. If a torn ligament is subjected to stress by the following manoeuvres, the patient experiences severe pain. If we go for inversion of the plantar flex foot for anterior tubulofibular ligament sprain, we go for inversion in neutral position for complete lateral collateral ligament sprain. Eversion in neutral position for medial collateral ligament sprain. Here we can see a sprained ankle and the contusion caused because of the injury. Now let's see what are the radiological examination findings that we can get in the sprain of ankle. X-rays of the ankle, anterior, posterior and lateral are usually normal because soft tissue injuries cannot be noted in the common radiograph. In some cases, stress X-rays may be done to judge the severity of the sprain. A tilt of the talus greater than 20 degree on forced inversion or eversion indicate a complete tear of lateral or medial collateral ligament respectively. Treatment. It depends upon the grade of sprain. Grade 1, below knee plaster cast for 2 weeks followed by mobilization. Grade 2, below knee cast for 4 weeks followed by mobilization. Grade 3, below knee cast for 6 weeks followed by mobilization. Now what is chronic ankle sprain? Chronic recurrent sprained ankle is a disabling condition if a cause of physiotherapy and modification issue has not helped, or detailed evaluation with MRI and arthroscopy may be necessary. Pain in a number of these so-called chronic ankle sprain is in fact due to impingement of the scarred capsule or chondromalacia of the talus. Arthroscopy is a good technique for diagnosis and treatment of such cases. That's it from the today's session. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Hope you are satisfied with this digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will try to resolve it. Thank you very much.